Wakanda swagger, I'm the blackest panther. Wakanda, y'all are wasting y'all time. I spend it, but I ain't wasting a dime. Might do some favors, but I ain't breaking my spine.
Your girl has been calling for days. I get known different ways. Wall is parades. Yeah, we like, none of my people are patient. We look like we on a vacation. Get no invitation.
Y'all all with it and y'all talk a lot, but y'all ain't got the heart to do the mission.
Yeah.
I'm hard-headed like the juggernaut, but there ain't nothing I could do to listen.
No.
I'm authentic and I walk around like I just ate, but let you do the dishes.
Yeah.
I'm Clark Kent, but mix the Autobots and mix with everything that you've been missing. Please get back and don't get involved. Freaking sick, I need a pad of walls. Mean, I'm the king, heavy crown, heavy rain, cat and dogs. Homie with me if you're asking for it. There ain't much that he be asking for. He just wanna have a paddock on with a watch face.
The NFL on EA Sports has come to the Twin Cities at U.S. Bank Stadium in downtown Minneapolis. The scene a short time ago, this crowd decked out in purple, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football, folks, as the Vikings get set to do battle with the Dallas Cowboys. This is taken about 7 yards deep, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The first carry now for Dalvin Cook. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up some down.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
On second down, Cook. Space to maneuver at the 40. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Vikings. A big play there. 71 yards. And the Vikings have taken a first quarter lead. And personally, what a start for him to get in the end zone from that distance here on the first drive.
And it has the defense tearing up their defensive goals for the game, doesn't it? Because nowadays, when we talk to all the coaches, they don't talk about limiting yards per carry and those things. They just talk about limiting explosive plays, whether it's through the air or on the ground. And anything, an explosive play on the ground, usually, what, 10, 12-yard runs? This one was way more than that. They've got to go back to the drawing board and try and shut it down.
So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. He finds an opening past the 40. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he's going to get this to the 40-yard line. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. They go play action here on first down. And, oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Michael Gallup, 60 yards. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. Extra point splits the uprights, and we are tied at 7. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Here's Murray. Space to maneuver at the 40. Latavius Murray, 20, 10, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Latavius Murray, 75 yards, and the Vikings get the quick strike touchdown. Well called, well blocked, and then he just made a great play. That was an athlete going a long way.
Yeah, how about the suddenness, too, of just getting there and taking off and going? for the defensive guys, plays like that really hurt.
Bailey now to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And now here come the Cowboys. And they'll just simply looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down. A second down throw for Prescott. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a third down. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. And he's able to hook up with Michael Gallup. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And it'll bring up a second and 13. They'll pitch it out to Elliott. And some room to maneuver. The 20. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. A big run there. 29 yards and a first.
That's how you get right up off of the mat, because on the last play, they stoned him in the backfield and dropped for a loss. But he's the type of guy that scared me a little bit, because he's not daunted. Just got right back up, showed some confidence, and picked up a first down with his very next run.
And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. 12 more yards there and another first down. They'll try to throw down. Prescott. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Anderson Dejo. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at the 20. Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. And he will lose yardage on the play. Back at his own 19-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Handoff comes to Cook. And not a whole lot to speak of there as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. Jalen Smith, the Notre Dame man, in on the tackle.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
On third down, Cousins. And this one is incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback, but when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need some heat on it, it helps to have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
And now it's the punter Weil on as he sends this one away. That'll for only 7 in this game, a touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
There they are, able able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. That one goes for 36 yards. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down just inside the 5-yard line. Linval Joseph able to collapse the pocket and drop him for a loss of a yard. So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, second and goal. They get it to him running left. And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Ezekiel Elliott, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And it'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And out now come the Vikings. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
Back to the ground, this time Cook. And he will make his way back to where he started from, and that's all, as we will make our way to the 2-minute warning. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. More from Minneapolis after this. Cousins from the gun on third. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 38. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
Offensively, when you see cover two, the thought has to go through the quarterback's head. Drive the football when making throws. It's not just the deep guys covering. It's the guys underneath you have to be careful of. Drive your throw. Otherwise, you see what result.
There he goes, left side. Touchdown, Cowboys. Two first-half touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys have broken the tie. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead is now 21-14. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Vikings offense gets set to take over here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Going right side here, and that's complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there, a 22.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. On first down, Murray. And he's got this one across midfield into Cowboy territory. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Again, this is Cook. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast. He stopped behind the line of scrimmage. They'll wind up losing three, and now it's third down. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Now Cousins. Looking for his tight end Rudolph, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker Jalen Smith. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops.
Yeah, he's just trying to throw this ball into the hole in the zone, but those windows can open and close quickly, especially in the middle of the field. So if the timing's not right, we'll see interceptions like that one right there.
That's into the hands of Gallup over the middle. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 15 yards is the pick up there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down. On first and 10, Prescott. And now he'll tuck it and run. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Second down, Prescott. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. And a stoppage here, a timeout before this third down play takes place. As they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. On third down, it's Prescott. The Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack. Danielle Hunter. He's the one that gets him down. It'll be a loss of five, and it'll bring up fourth down. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Out come the Cowboys now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Linval Joseph. In there to get him, his second sack now of the afternoon. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Looking to throw, Prescott. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Prescott on first down. Now he'll be wrapped up around the waist and pushed down. Eric Kendricks in from his linebacker spot. He's able to drop him for a loss of about 10. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Now Prescott completes it right side to Cooper. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down.
Doesn't matter whether it's a zone coverage or a man coverage, the drag route can be effective when it's run well.
And the Vikings with an extra defender in the secondary on third.
Playing coverage here.
Throwing, Prescott. And the third pass falls incomplete.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys.
But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, help force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. It'll go as a punt of 32 yards. And the Vikings will take over here, first and 10. It's the Vikings' turn on offense. We get ready for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half?
Because no, tell me.
That's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker boards?
Yeah, those two. Part of the thinking when you bring in extra tight ends, you're hoping that each of your guys gets those one-on-one blocks and creates a crease for your runner. You know what the converse is, though? You've got to win those one-on-one blocks, and when you don't, that's the result you end up with.
A loss yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Cousins now on second down. And he will go down. A Cowboys sack.
So what's the word I'm looking for here about how this drive just started?
Disjointed?
I'll go with that one. I mean, think about it. First down, took a bad loss on a running play. Take the sack on second down. Now they got to come up with something big here on third.
And that is incomplete.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, make a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
Cousins in the offense is going to stay out there. They're going to try on fourth down. They'll indeed go for it. It's Cousins. And this is going to be incomplete. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. They were forced to punt last time. Now I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do they. Great starting spot. Great opportunity to run your full playbook. They want to take a shot here, they can go ahead and do it.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Second and five after the 5-yard completion on first down. Prescott from the gun. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And he will score. Touchdown, Cowboys. Dak Prescott, a 13-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. And he's got it up and through. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that ails over the end line. The Vikings offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense.
And the pressure too much that time as Cousins goes down. Jalen Smith leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of 6. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. Cousins. Open here, Adam Thielen. And he'll get it up near 35, right at the 34 here. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down.
If he's their best threat on offense, use your number one cover guy on defense. It doesn't matter about size.
They have had him locked up. That just his first catch of the game. Big reason why they're down. The Vikings on third down. Not good. 0 for 4 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. They'll run it. Here's Cook. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave them with a fourth down.
How about the fellas with the stars on the side of their helmets rising up on defense? We always hear about the Cowboys' rushing offense. Their rush defense is pretty good as well, I think because they're so cohesive. Defensive line, linebackers really work well together.
Hey. running for it. Here's Cook. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. On first and 10, Cousins. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And they board the ground just shy of midfield. 12 yards there as they move the chains. But correct me if I'm wrong, you know, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Now a play fake here on first down. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Malik Collins coming up the middle, gets him there for a loss of about 9.
Rhino!
Now a second down throw for Cousins. Incomplete. Right side, the tight end Rudolph. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line.
This game just keeps evolving and changing, doesn't it? You got a tight end who can move around a lot, not necessarily using a big body on him. Sometimes you take a corner, a better cover guy, and put him on him and try and take him out of the game, as we've seen in this one.
You're exactly right. They've taken him out of the game. That was just his first catch. Big reason they're losing right now.
And he takes this down deep on the Cowboys' side of the field. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. They'll run with Cook. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much right after that as he's brought down. On second and goal, Cook waiting in the backfield all alone. He's going to get it running right. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
Well, sometimes I get caught in hyperbole, but I think they desperately need to punch this one in. They're running out of time.
Yeah, two-score game, second half, you're down here. This is the time to put it in the end zone.
Man, not going to get much better than this for an opportunity.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Here's Cousins. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, oh, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum. And even more hope when they had to slog their way downfield. They got the touchdown, but it's almost like, yeah, you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again.
And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout as they'll talk things over to this upcoming second down play. Second and 6, just inside the 30. Well, Prescott here to throw. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. The Cowboys on their way to victory as they take a knee. The Vikings going to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 1:06 left to go in the game. The Cowboys on their way to victory as they take a knee. Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right? Just us against the world and get it done. How happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something. And they did in this one. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you prime the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughan. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. From Minneapolis, so long, everybody.